Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar and in this video we are going to demonstrate CI/CD pipeline on Power BI by using Azure DevOps. Let's begin. This is my Power BI console. Let me create a workspace. I have created a demo workspace. Developer develop the Power BI file at their local machine and upload the file on GitHub. I will use this GitHub in Azure DevOps for the source code. I am going to use Power BI Actions plugins to set up CI/CD approach. This plugin support two types of the connection service. One is service principal and second is user. For the demonstration, I am going to use service principal because it is a most trusted and recommended approach for connection service. Let's create service principal before setup CI/CD. Follow the steps in this article. Go ahead and connect your Azure AD. This is my Azure portal. Click on Azure Active Directory. Then click on App Registration. Click on New Registration. Give the name of the application. Select the appropriate option. Since my Power BI workspace and Azure Active Directory in same domain, so I am going to select single tenant. If your Power BI workspace and Azure Active Directory are located into different directory, then you can go with multi-tenant. Leave the blank redirection URI, or you can give the redirection UI based on your requirement. Go ahead and register it. Now you need to create a security group for this application. Click on groups and create a new group. Group type is security. Give the group name. In the members section, select the application and click on select. Go ahead and create it. Security group has been created. Now go back your Power BI workspace. You need to provide access to this security group on Power BI APIs. For that, click on three dots, go to settings and admin portal. If you are normal user of the Power BI, then you will not see all the options. You should be admin of Power BI portal, then you will be able to provide access. Now go to tenant settings and go to developer settings. Click on allow service principal to use Power BI APIs. By default it is disabled. Go ahead and enable it and select the specific security group. Give the security group name to which you want to grant permission. We just created this security group. Go ahead and apply. It is going to take few minutes. Maximum it will take 15 minutes. Go back your home and click on workspace. You also need to provide access on your workspace. Click on three dots and go to workspace access. Select the service principal group and give the admin access. It means that this service principle can access, upload, delete any object from this workspace. Now we are all set to create CI/CD pipeline. So go to Azure DevOps and create a new project if no project yet. Let's create the repo for this project. Give the URL of the repository. Import it. File successfully imported. Now we require to create a build pipeline. Click on pipelines. Where is my code? It is on Azure repo. Now configure the pipeline. Click on Starter Pipeline, delete the lines and include a task copy file. When you include this task, you will see a settings hyperlink. Click on it. After click on it, you can see a window in the right hand side. In this build pipeline, we don't require a hard code build process. We just need to copy file from the source location and publish in publishing area. This is going to be my source location. I want to copy only .pbx file and I want to copy .pbx file on this staging directory. Click on advance. I am okay with the default option. Go ahead and click on add button. In the second task, we are going to publish the file into staging area. Click on settings and I am good with these options. If you want to copy or publish the file on a file share, then you can select a file share option and provide the information about file share. I am going to publish the file into Azure pipelines. Go ahead and add it. Once everything is okay, click on Save and Run button. It has been completed. You can verify by clicking. You can see a drop container, and in the drop container, you can see Power BI file. Now we have completed CI or build pipeline. Let's go ahead and configure CD pipeline. To set up the CD pipeline, click on release. No release at this moment. Click on pipeline. Let's first add artifact. The project and select the source. Go ahead and add it. Now click on stage. Click a empty job. Give the stage name. Now click on task. Then click on agent job. Since I am going to use Power BI action plugins, search Power BI, then add Power BI action. This plugin will be available only when you install this plugin from MarketPlace. Go ahead and add it. Now select the Power BI action You can change the display name, the authentication type. There are two authentication type. One is user and second is service principal. I am going to use a service principal for authentication. Now you require to configure the service principal. Click on new button. Give the service principal ID. Service principal equal to client ID. Go to Active Directory. Then app registration. We created this app for the SPN. It will be your service principal ID. Service principal key is a client secret. To get a client secret, click on certificate and secret and click on new client secret. Select the option never expires and add it. This is your client secret key. Copy and save in secured location because this key will not be available when we move from this window. Tenant ID is a Azure Active Directory tenant. Go back overview and this is your tenant ID. Give the service principal name. Select the option grant access permission to all pipelines and save it. Once you save the service principal, it is going to select it automatically. Now select the action, support multiple action like create new workspace, delete workspace, update data source or upload Power BI report. Since I am going to upload a Power BI report, select this option. Give the workspace name. This is my workspace demo and source file. Select the drop container. You can go with the option override Power BI files or create if the workspace does not exist. Leave other option as a default. Go ahead and save it. Give the pipeline name. Now you are ready with both the CI/CD pipeline. Click build or CI pipeline and run pipeline. It's success. Artifact has been produced. Let's go ahead and run the release pipeline. Create release. At this moment we have only one stage. I am good with the artifact and create it. Release one has been created. Click on deploy. Request in queued. You can watch logs. It's successfully completed. Let's verify the workspace in Power BI. Report has been successfully deployed on demo workspace. You can see here. Your data set is ready. Go ahead and click on report. This is the sample report for this demonstration. So we have successfully completed CI/CD pipeline on Power BI Workspace by using Azure DevOps. In this video, that's all. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.